Matt Zuccarello is a Minnesota Wild. Matt Zuccarello is a Minnesota Wild. Matt Zuccarello is a Minnesota Wild. We took him from Dallas and everybody is unhappy. Why is people unhappy? Maybe it's the term. The term is a little bit long, yes, but it's fine. We are nodding in the cap toss because we signed Zuccarello. He is fine. Stop being mad about buying things. Oh, okay, so the term is fine. Okay, good. Okay, but how about the no movement clause? That kind of makes us exposed during the expansion draft.
I hate it when you make sense.
Weren't you supposed to be on vacation? What is up, guys? Welcome to the free agency frenzy that just happened, and I will make a video on the frenzy that happened around the league after this one, because right now I have to focus on the Minnesota Wild side of things, because guess what? A lot of things has happened also in Minnesota Wild land. Mainly, Matt Zuccarello, as you heard in the intro, is a Minnesota Wild. Big news, good news in my opinion, I like Matt Zuccarello. Then you look at the contract in depth and it's becoming less good news. Let's start with the positive. Matt Zuccarello is a Minnesota Wild and he's gonna help us tremendously. Goal scoring was probably our biggest issue all of last season. We went 8 games in the last 24 where we didn't score a single goal. We got shut out 8 out of 24 games in our last stretch. That is simply not okay. We missed the playoff due to those lack abilities of scoring and inability from the forwards especially. We had a lot of defensive scoring. Spurgeon did fine. Dumba, while he was there, great, great, great as an offensive player. But we lacked the offensive goal scoring. As good as Donato was, and as much as I like Donato, and as much as I think he improved us as he came in, he should not have been the only dynamo we had offensively. Parise kind of vanished after a fine start to the season. Stoll was nowhere. Suka kind of vanished as well. Fiala never really turned it on. There was a lot of players who just didn't really perform well enough in the terms of scoring. Not great, not ideal. And without scoring, guess what? You aren't going to make the playoff. Matt Zuccarello will help us immediately. He had a fine season with Dallas. He went from there on the trade deadline. He was screwed. I liked him. He wants to be here. Great. Even better. In his interviews, he sounds fantastically welcoming to the city. Although if you ask Fenton, it's because he's a lizard, which don't read Fenton news because they're just confusing you. It's not even a knock against Fenton. I actually like the deal, but it's just confusing when he kind of says the reason he's here is because he's a lizard. And actually, not even me that makes it up. It's on the Twitter website that Minnesota Wild runs. They put a quote where he said he has a lizard tongue or something like that. It's generally confusing and I will put that in the description just for you guys to read it. It's just confusing. You guys tell me what that meant. I don't know. But regardless of the fact, he's a Minnesota Wild player. He will help with scoring. He is going to be good for at least 3 of the 5 years that he's here. And now begins the negative. He is on a 5-year deal for $6 million per. That's a little bit too long. I would have preferred it if it was 3 years. Had it been 3 years for $6 million, I would have thought that was a brilliant deal. I would have been up to in the moons and being super happy with it. I thought that was probably what we were expecting him to get. 5 years is a bit long, but okay, it's livable because we won't be in a cap crunch that majorly before his contract is up. If you look at the players we got, we have Kaprizov in 4 years needing to be resigned. That's gonna hurt. But at the same time, at that point, Koivu's contract is off the board. Ennis's contract is off the board. I'm assuming Stoll's contract is off the board. Yes, there's gonna be other contracts that probably have somewhat replaced him, but there is definitely wiggle room in that area. And it's only the last contract. If you really need to, you can buy him out. You can trade him to a team that then buys him out. We've seen that this year. So it's not out of the window that he won't play all 5 years in the Minnesota Wild jersey, but I think he will at least play 4 of them. We have fine cap space. Cap space is not our issue. I'm not necessarily going to say this is gonna hurt us. His cap room, fine. He's a good player. He proved us. Had it just been that, I would have been totally down for the signing. The negative part comes in the part that is written with small letters. His no movement clause. And this kind of worries me a little bit because if you look at this in the terms of normality, I would not be worried. But look at it in the terms of an expansion draft, and I'm generally breaking it. We have to protect 7 forwards. We already have to protect Parise and Suter. We cannot avoid protecting them. They are going to have to be protected. They have the no movement clause at that point. Now Matt Zuccarello goes into the list. Okay, who else do we have to protect the forward? We can protect 7. So outside Zuccarello and Zach Parise, we also have to protect Luke Conan, Ericsson Ek. We need to protect Fiala. We need to protect Donato, Green Ray, and last but not least, Zucker. That's 8. One of those last 5 players is going to be on the chopping board. So for me, that leaves probably Zucker a little bit on the chopping board, which sucks because Zucker is a great player. At that time, he would be 29, which is not a bad age, but it's the age where, you know, if we put him up there, there's a good chance he's gonna get picked. I would say put him up, hope that this doesn't happen, but he will probably be taken. Leave it there and then say, okay, no trading. We don't need to do exactly what we did with Alex Tuck. I feel like that was a bad move on our behalf, but we don't need to give up more players to avoid a Zucker being taken. It's a really bad situation, but it is what it is. And there's still a lot of years left for things to go odd, for things to go weird, for trades to happen, for us to trade Zucker for somebody else in a pick. And all of a sudden that he's probably going to be put into the perspective of an expansion draft. We keep all the guys, we get a pick, we draft somebody nicely, and all of a sudden that worry with Zuccarello is all of a sudden gone, and Zuccarello turned out to be amazing. But as to kind of debrief, I am happy with the Zuccarello trade. I'm not against it. I like Vincent trying to do it. I think it will improve us. It gives us a general chance of making the playoff. It is going to make us a more of a contender. Does it make us favorite? No. Does it even make us close to it? Not really. Does it give us a genuine shot of being in the playoff where everything can happen as we saw this year? Yes. Yes, it does. Oh, absolutely it does. So, velkommen, Mats. Håber du nyder det i Minnesota. Also, I know that was Danish, but Norwegian and Danish are so similar, there's a good chance he can understand what I just said. Outside that, we also signed Ryan Hartman, Luke Johnson, and Gabriel Dormant. The two latter I am not too sure about. I know Luke Johnson has played in Chicago and has done alright without brillianting too much. And the same with Dormant, it's two-way contracts. They might turn good, but they will probably start in Iowa, see what they do there, and then we can kind of look into it from there. Ryan Hartman, he has pretty much been all over Central, hasn't he? He's from Nashville, Chicago, he has been pretty much anywhere. Now he is in Minnesota. I wouldn't be surprised if once Arizona goes to the Central, he just moves over there just to complete the cycle. We signed him for 2 years at $1.9 million per year. Not bad either. That's a player I see playing alongside Foligno and maybe Nico Strom. Not a problem. That's a fine player. That's going to be a gritty line. That's going to be really, really annoying to play. And if you look at what the other teams got, yeah, we need grit. We need a lot of grit in this division because we might not be the best division anymore. We are the one who's going to knock each other out the most. Yeah, especially now that I just seen that Colorado has decided to get Capri. This division is just going to be a fight club. I will, again, more to talk about in the next video. Focus on the Minnesota Wild. We got Ryan Hartman. Fine player. Fine term. Fine contract. I like that as a fourth liner. He is going to be fine for us. Did we get younger this offseason? Not really. But we didn't get worse. I think we've done fine this free agency period. At least the first day. There's still more to come. There's still a few players out there. There's still going to be interesting things happening. There's still going to be bombs and explosions and everything else that's going to happen. But for now, we look fine. But that was just my quick take on what the Minnesota Wild is kind of at right now. We are in a fine state, but there's definitely room to maneuver. But we are not as bad as it looked before today. I like the Zuccarello deal. I like the Hartman deal. I like what we've done. There's worries. There's future things that could go into a bad state. Some of them could backfire. That happens all the time. But I feel like we have something brewing here that is interesting. At least it's going to be fun to watch. And I don't know what to expect this year, but I feel like at least we're moving somewhere, which is nice to see. So optimism, cautiously, is probably my keyword right now. But let me know, what do you think? Welcome Zuccarello to the Minnesota Wild. Let me know, what do you think about the signing? Is it good, bad? Should Fenton go? Should he not? I'm actually going to defend Fenton here, say that was a smart move. But with that, I will bid you all adieu. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.